Ladies and gentlemen, a Kinguin Pro League 2015. So we just saw Firebat get reverse sweep crushed by Savic, and we're about to see him play a second game. He's going to be up against Strifecro, who is, I believe, still the leading player of the entire event. So Firebat, if he wins this, is going to be able to secure himself a 4-3, which is going to equalize him with Savic, the opponent that just beat him. Otherwise, he's going to be down 3-4, which means he's going to have had two losses in a row, which is not something that's very easy to recover from.
That's for sure. And his tiebreaker is not that bad, but it's not good either. It's 10-10, so it's basically zero for now.
Yeah, and if he does lose against Strifecro for whatever reason, and he ends up, you know, going two wins against him at the very least, then the tiebreaker will increase because Strifecro is by far the leading player so far. So that will increase the tiebreaker for Firebat.
Well, we'll have to see what will be the outcome of the match, because this is the top match of the two best players in the world, maybe top three players in the world. I would say Life Coach joins those two guys, and we have the matchups for the both of the players, right? Strifecro will play Mage, Rogue Warrior, Firebat. So never mind. Firebat will be playing Druid, Paladin, Warlock, and so what can we say about
this lineup? No classes overlap for one. I feel like Strifecro's Warrior might get, you know, hard countered around. Yeah, I think Firebat is maybe playing around the Warrior here for Strifecro.
No, I don't think he's playing around the Warrior.
It seems to happen to work.
Yeah, but when does Strifecro play Warrior? It's not like a common sight to behold, right?
Yeah, it's not something I see very often. Maybe he was expecting Firebat to play Freeze Mage, because he has played quite a bit of it in the past. So maybe it's a counter pick for Strifecro that's going to backfire, possibly. We saw Strifecro play Warrior before, but not nearly as frequently as some of the other players out there. So the first match will be Strifecro's Warrior versus Firebat's Druid. Fibonacci says, and you can quote him on that, the Druids are not that hard to beat, but that doesn't seem to be the experience of most Warrior players out there. But Fibonacci is something of a very special Warrior player. So what he feels is an okay matchup, maybe what feels like a crushing one for a lot of people. So I'm not sure if Strifecro's opinion of the Warrior versus Druid matchup lines up with that of Fibonacci. I feel like Druid is still a bit favored here.
Everyone I know says that standard Warrior lists are basically crushed by Druids.
Yeah, that's how I feel, but Fibonacci says otherwise, so we'll have to see how this is gonna go. I mean, I'm really eager to see how Strifecro plays a control Warrior against this Druid, and it really does come down, though, to Wild Growth and Innervates. Those are really crucial cards for the Druid to find, and if he does, that will be a big deal.
Well, even without the Wild Growth, it's still okay. Because you have so many big
OTK
creatures.
Oh, wow! Wow, it's OTK Warrior!
No, this is great.
Strifecro, Nairia, did you reincarnate into Strifecro? An average height Asian? Nairia is now an average height Asian. Who plays OTK Warrior besides Nairia? That's like the first time I've seen anyone but him play that. Am I just wrong? I might just be
that's
wrong.
A good question. I'm browsing through my head. I can't say I've seen anyone playing OTK apart from Nairia.
That's the only guy I can really associate with the deck. Wow, that is amazing!
Everyone, get in here!
What if he plays that card? What if?
I think he has to.
But he doesn't, because OTK doesn't require it, but it makes the whole thing so much more fun. I mean, the best OTKs are essentially control Warriors with the OTK sprinkled in. But
like spiced,
yeah, you just put a little bit of OTK spice on your Warrior and you smell better for days. Look at your Warrior, now look at mine, now look at your Warrior, now back at mine. How do you feel, OTK spice? What have I done? All right, back to the game, ladies and gents. So Firebat has a pretty good curve in hand. He's got a Doctor 4.
Still, the Druid is an awful matchup for OTK Warriors, right?
Yeah, I don't think it got better. It's just that I think it's even worse than for regular control Warriors, unless I'm mistaken. Because they have even less ways to really deny the board. Unless they run the version that has two brawls to make sure they really don't... The board doesn't get out of hand. Okay, I think I do prefer this Harrison Jones. But you might want to keep it for Gore Hal. But never mind. No, you can't do
you
that.
Can you can't be greedy.
Yeah, mind that. There's no way.
Not every warrior plays Gore Hal. And that the Harrison Jones represents basically an Ancient of Lore in this situation.
I don't know, man. I like Harrison Jones, but Dr. Balanced, you know? You can't...
It glowed green for a second, so maybe you play it.
Yeah, that's the way it works. Oh, man. Strifecro finds Emperor, though, and this is a very important card for him to have. Very important card in combo decks. Brawl and pray that everything but a Boombot goes.
I think so.
All right. Well... Will Strifecro's prayers be heard?
And oh.
Youch. Three. Four. Oh. Dr. Balance, ladies and gents.
So one free attack.
Sorry about that, says Firebat. Surely feeling very sorry for his opponent.
Sorry, Bat.
Sorry, Bat. Okay. That's his new name, I guess. After Firebed. Because he never wakes up, we now have Sorry Bat. And he gets the Harrison Jones if he wants it, but he's gonna keep it for Gore Hal. Or just seal the game without allowing for shield block, shield slam.
If I execute Big Game Hunter, I don't think there's a way to work and make a comeback.
Yeah.
The Gore Hal is a great answer to a Dr. Boom, but if it's played on turn 4, it's not.
It's not a great answer to Dr. 4.
Yeah.
No, it's not. Oh, man. How does Strifecro win this?
I don't see any
way
out.
I guess Emperor turns 7 into Alexstrasza yourself, but look at the hand from Firebat. He's getting a Black Knight here, which is... Even better than he could have had. Like, this is just a perfect hard counter. Every line of play that Strifecro took got punished. And that's one thing I like about Strifecro, though. He's able to take it in stride and not care much. Like, he got the most amazing RNG recently. Did you see it with the Blinktron?
Yeah, I saw that, yeah.
And he literally was, oh, okay. I guess I win. I guess I like zero reaction. That was even Colento reacts, you know, more emotionally to stuff like this. And I was like, wait, what? Yeah, so I don't think he'll be, you know, demotivated by this. Firebat's Druid is now locked out, so he can't go back to it. But he still has a pretty good lineup. You know, there's a Paladin and a Warlock in Firebat's deck, which, you know, both of those are capable of taking games off of Warrior, even Combo Warrior. Although Paladin, I mean, I think it's still a good matchup. It's just that Brawl becomes even more important in that matchup if you're playing two of those. But Firebat has no idea this is OTK.
Yeah, he has no idea yet. The Warrior should win against the Warlock almost always. It's such, like, the OTK is such important tactic against the Warlock. You don't even know what hit you.
Yeah, you have no clue at all. Yeah. What happened to you?
I'm not sure how it works against the Paladin. It depends a lot on the amount of taunt creatures in the Paladin deck, I would say. That's the problem?
That's a problem, but Brawl and Gore Hal are there to tackle it many times. And you usually make sure you keep an answer to it.
Right?
Yeah, some decks do run the one. I know Neria had a few variants depending on what he was facing most. And against control, it's not, you know, nonsensical to run Spellbreakers. At least it wasn't a while back. So, Strifecro is going for Rogue, and Firebat is going to be playing Paladin. So there could be an equalization here of the score at the very least.
Well, now it's a good sign for Strifecro that he did change the Warrior, because...
Yeah, he saw the lineup that he was up against with Paladin and Warlock. So I don't think if you want your tiebreaker, there's no way you do that.
He just wanted to avoid the execution for the Warrior. Maybe he would get like a one win with the Warrior in the first game and just, you know...
Yeah, the thing is, OTK Warrior...
From under the knife.
Yeah, OTK Warrior isn't even bad against Paladin because the game is so slow. You have time to draw, you have time to get your pieces, and all you need is one good turn, in effect. Which is why I think it's a much better deck against control than it is against midrange, in general.
Maybe you're right. Okay, we got another bug with the spectator. This is so annoying, you know?
Spectator glitch! Yeah, it's would you say you're a spectator mad? Failfish. So I'm just curious to see really what Paladin deck Firebat brought, because I remember he brought a while back a very control heavy deck that was akin to that of Purple, but it's a very, very slow deck that just doesn't die because it heals up so much. But I don't know if it's very fitted.
He played
with
that.
Rogue.
He played that. I don't think he will bring it to again without a whole lineup that will support this. You know.
I have one question.
Yeah. Oh, what? No way! What? What is happening?
We're playing.
Vanish.
We're,
did they see Vanish?
We're casting Jankcro today. I don't know what's happening. This is Jankcro. It's not the usual player we cast.
I was really tired because of the whole traveling thing and you know, stuff happening, but now I'm just on my toes here.
I don't even know what's going
and
on.
Gang up. Wow.
I'm in love with this. So he does play the fish. He has to be playing the fish.
You mean the more like Oracle?
Yeah, but they're fish, right?
Yeah, I know they're fish, but maybe some less experienced viewers are not.
Okay, the Cold Light fish. Yeah, the Cold Light Oracles are effectively referred to as fish by
everyone.
Everyone, pretty much. So if you find the fish, you win. If you don't find the fish, you don't win. It's a very simple equation. Oh, that's not a bad top deck. Thing is, when do you play your Blood Mage? Because, I mean, Blood Mage Backstab allows you to deal with that Acolyte.
I think you don't want to deal with that Acolyte. I would say that you want to
damage
it even. Yeah.
Well, you haven't found the fish. I guess you just play SI, make him draw a card, and then finish it off. You don't give away your hand by telling him your mill.
Yeah, probably.
All right. There's a lay on hands here for Firebat. And if he finds a True Sword Champion, he's gonna be pretty happy here. Shredder's good as well. Not a bad one. Although I suspect he might get a sap treatment.
There's a sap. There's even a second one. But still, the gang up feels really blank.
It's useless right now. He might just go for like attack with the 3-3 into the 4-3 or sap and then set up a better fan of knives later on. Like, he needs to get himself card draw in some way. And now he can deal with Lothab with his board if it's played.
Well, you can
take 5, I guess.
5 minutes break?
Yeah.
It's a Kit Kat.
Just go full face here?
Yeah, you go full face. You go full aggro mode.
With male rogue.
Yeah, you put your opponent in a situation when he doesn't know what is going on.
Emperor is getting so much value here. Lay on hands, Harrison Jones, Shredder, Double Consec, and Dr. Balanced. Are you kidding me? This is the craziest Emperor I've ever seen.
Oh, I just remembered. RDU is playing OTK Warrior for Pinnacle. When we're talking about the OTKs.
Say what?
RDU
was using Sapper? RDU was using Goblin Sapper?
Oh, okay.
Was he? I've never...
No, I was telling that he was using the OTK Warrior In the Pinnacle qualifier.
In the Pinnacle, well. Okay, yeah, that's... I mean, OTK War has been around forever. It's just that Neri is the only player I've really seen play it in tournaments. I've seen a lot of people play the card, the deck, but just not really in tournament settings.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, man.
But let's go back to this game.
Yep, so Fan of Knives draws you a card. You could find the fish, and
well,
you can wipe the board.
Well, you have to kill the Lotus and the Emperor for sure.
Yeah.
You can't allow them to be either vanished or on board, because it's too much damage and too powerful effect to leave it just in the open.
Yeah, Firebat is playing the very turtle-ish deck with the Guardian of Kings and Lay on Hand.
And now you can vanish, give him two bombs in hand.
So there's how many cards in the Firebat's hand right now? There's total of 7. So if he does vanish, it fills up the hand completely.
Yes, but then the bombs will be just replayed and he will get 4 bombs instead of 2.
That's the same as Sapping Boom. You just put more bombs on the board.
What about playing Deathlord and...
What about Emperor Coin Sap, Dr. Boom?
I don't like that.
You don't like that?
No.
Okay. I just figured the mana reduction would have been somewhat interesting, but...
I would say it's Deathlord into Goblin.
Sapper?
Yeah.
Alright, that's gonna get punished very hard in this circumstance because of the double consec, or even just equality consec.
Would you play equality when you have double?
Nah, never. Probably just consec, and then...
Okay, so he goes for the Emperor Sap, probably.
I don't think there's any other line of play after Emperor that makes any sense if he decides to go for that. He's gonna have to do it fast because the rope's coming out. Alright, he does get it off. Alright. Right at the very end, he goes for the Emperor Sap play. So Firebat's gonna have to replay his Dr. Boom for full value. If he wants to get it off, again, it's not even guaranteed. But Strifecro really wants to find the Cold Lights. Those are gonna be very important for him.
Without the Cold Lights, he doesn't have a win condition here, so that's the problem.
Unless I'm mistaken, there's something about Strifecro's mill deck that I'm not aware of. This should be the problem. Well, Fan of Knives is a good pickup.
Is it? You get 12 damage to the face.
Right. You're right. I mean, if you vanish, Dr. Boom and the bomb go back to the hand, so you're still going to be stuck with the same problem. But you could go for Vanish and Deathlord, perhaps. That way you set up a decent board and you can kill the bombs with Fan of Knives later. Like the 3,000 wave of him.
Oh, that's so awful.
It is, but... This is the weakness of mail, I guess, is when you don't find the Cold Lights.
If you face Dr. Boom?
I mean, I almost feel like... Oh man, and now Firebat knows what type of deck this is for sure, 100%. He wasn't sure what it was about, and now he sees it. Now Strifecro gave his hand away, so Firebat's gonna be prepared to play against Mill.
And now he can drop Dr. Boom and 2 bombs.
He loses Sylvanas, but I don't think that's a big loss for him.
I don't think so either.
I can tell you one thing, that Lay on Hands is not getting played. Neither is that Harrison Jones. Unless he really needs to remove a big weapon, but...
Unless he really needs to play a creature and he doesn't have other one.
Yeah.
And then you force him to destroy a dagger.
I think I like double shredder and double bomb here.
Double How do you like shredder, that? Double bomb.
Instead of Dr. Boom, bomb.
That seems to be really good. I don't like the double consecration.
It's a very all-in play, but...
And double bombs? No, pile the shredder, right?
Yeah, probably. The bombs are fun, but I don't think they work very well in this specific case after you're gone for double consec. Oh man, what a horrible hand here for Strifecro. For a mill rogue, this is as bad as it gets.
You need more mail, man.
That's I guess you could be stuck with prep and backstabs, and that'd be worse, but... Yeah, it'd probably be a little worse. No, Vanish was used on Dr. Boom. Like a one card Vanish. What a
yeah, that's
crazy.
Awful.
Yeah, it's the worst. It's the last thing you want to have to deal with. Strifecro weighing his options, but it's not as though he's got too many of them.
Well, the Drake will certainly help here.
What?
Well,
I
you,
mean, you don't have meta to do anything.
Something different.
Yeah, next turn it might help out quite a bit. Alright, so he knows there's a Dr. Boom left, so that Fan of Knives is now dead, and Firebat is in fact playing a really heavy heal deck.
So, in theory, the Mill Rogue is in a really great matchup.
Yeah, but, in theory, this is an auto win, effectively, every time.
But Strifecro is struggling with the draw. That's the problem.
Yeah, this is not a match you expect to lose as Mill. You go into this and you basically think to yourself, oh, I've got this. And then Dr. Boom hits. And you don't have the answers to it. Because usually what you do is you just overdraw them with Collateral Call. And you then sap Dr. Boom and you're done with it. And
oh,
now...
Truce of the Champion. That's important.
Harrison was played to find for like an answer that's going to be more relevant. And he does find it. Well, not a bad minion. Ivy Cowl, that doesn't stand in the light.
So what does Strifecro need? The second Vanish?
Vanish. He needs Vanish. He needs to get Cold Light and then Vanish off of it. Or a Shadow Step into Cold Light into Vanish. He needs to find something amazing.
Not
what he's got.
It.
You know what? I'm not even sure what the Goblin Sappers do accomplish here. Like, I'm not sure I really like them in this deck, in this type of deck. I feel like they're not going to stick around often enough to be worth it, but I haven't really played around with their concept too much. Since the advent of the Mill Rogue.
So you have to use the Eviscerate for the Harrison Jones, and play...
Trade Lothab into... I guess you play Sapper and Eviscerate this turn.
Probably.
That's about it. That or you play Drake Backstab to kill a 2-3 and then trade away your Lothab into Harrison, but I don't think that's very nice. You could find a prep, though. If you do, you race ahead pretty well. Like, if you find a prep and you get to Eviscerate Harrison for 0 and then Backstab the 2-3...
Yeah, that would be really nice.
Yeah. What are the odds, though? It was like, he just put 3 Cold Lights in there. That's even less likely to happen.
Agent. Wow. That sucks.
Yeah, not exactly what he wants to see.
So he has to kill the Harrison, I would say?
Yeah, definitely.
Peacekeeper the Drake, right?
Yeah, Peacekeeper Drake trade. This is going to be essentially a long drawn out game. Strifecro needs to find Cold Light next turn. And
oh man, 6 bumps in one game.
That sounds balanced. Look at this. There's so much balance on the board.
Damage.
There is so much balance on this board. He needs to find Cold Light into Cold Light into Cold Light, and that wouldn't even do anything.
Wow.
Escape Concede is a great play.
You can't do anything here.
I don't even know how Strifecro got into that position. Can you tell me exactly what happened since the start of this game? So what you do here is you eviscerate a bomb, get hit for 4. You SI a second bomb, you get hit for 4. Then you dagger up, attack a bomb, and then get hit for 4. Is that the way you do this?
I think you just concede. I don't see how he can win this game anymore. He is the mill deck and he has less cards than his opponents. Then his opponent.
Well, I mean, he can always just deadly eviscerate the Dr. Boom and maybe try to live. He's seen 2 consecs, so there's a faint possibility of that, but... Now, when I say faint, I mean... very faint.
Wow.
I mean, trading 3 boom bots will give him lethal, effectively.
What the hell?
Alright, so there's 11 damage on the board. True Silver Champion is lethal, but not quite there yet. Unless he trades the Boom Boss to up their damage.
Bombs, man.
Yeah, that's the way you have to do it. No, you can't sacrifice him anymore. That didn't quite hit the face.
How can Rogue kill you with one card when you have 19 points of life? I didn't see a point even in the healing.
I thought you were going to say 19 Boombots. I was going to say, yep, you're right. That's not going to do it. And Strifecro loses, having given away his opponent information about the Rogue deck as well. Yeah. That is not something you want to do. And Firebat is down to one last deck, having won
Strifecro
the first two.
Had really such bad match, bad draw, or it's just
terrible draw.
Sucks.
Terrible draw. Mill should not start off like this against a Paladin deck. This is very unfortunate. This was a really, really bad draw. And I feel like the Goblin Sapper doesn't really accomplish as much as perhaps other cards do in that deck. I mean, he's playing OTK Warrior and Mill Rogue. So if anything, that's at least a good spectacle.
Yeah, that's true.
At the very least, what I want to know is, what is his mage now? OTK, Archmage, Entenitis, Sorcerer's Apprentice with Echoes of Medivh or what? Like, what is he going to bring? Really what I want to know.
Maybe it will be a Fatigue Mage. Maybe.
Yeah, everything's possible. So Strifecro is going to be playing Rogue next up against Firebat's Warlock. So Warlock is the last deck that Firebat needs to win with. If it's Handlock, that's essentially an auto win for Mill. Unless, again,
and
they whiff.
And auto win
completely.
For Warrior, basically.
It's Warlock versus Rogue, but...
Oh, sorry. Yeah, but I'm saying that if he will win with the Rogue, then he will win with the Warrior also. Like 90%.
Most of the time. Well, against Warlock, I don't know. How likely do you really win that much against Warlock?
Well, I remember these situations like when OTK Warrior
with
was introduced.
Yeah, with OTK you win with... You're right. Never mind. Yeah. With OTK, you definitely do. You can play very slowly and you're able to remove
your minions.
You
don't care about the health points of your opponent. You just burst him down with one clean attack.
Yeah.
You just have to be sure that you will kill all those... counts or just silence them.
Alright, so Strifecro has the gang up and the sap. Gang up is dead now. Fan of Knives is also dead. You might keep a sap against Handlock if you think it's Handlock. Firebat's just gonna throw everything he's got on this board as fast as possible. There is no way he tries to tap here. Like, he is... I mean, he will probably tap the first two turns, perhaps, at the very most. Just to find something to drop, but... You don't want to get stuck in the collateral nightmare.
I don't think so. The Molten Giant is awful, though.
Mm-hmm. Not a very good card here for Firebat. Might just
and
get stuck
in the
heal boss
also. You have to drop the Black Knight on turn 6.
Yeah, as a Yeti.
Okay, maybe not. There's a Deathlord in this deck, right?
Oh yeah, you could get Deathlord value. That's right. I was reading a post recently about the value of Stampeding Kodo in this metagame.
Yeah, it is. It's crazy value.
Yeah. Well, Firebat does tap. He's not afraid of the Cold Light Shadow Step.
The Emperor might be crucial in this situation. I mean,
for Firebat?
Yeah, because you can drop it and just... You know, then reduce the cost of your cards so you can drop them more from your hand and then get vanished.
Prep vanished is just the sickest thing. Oh.
Well,
coin giant.
It's a coin giant, yeah.
I think you just drop BGH and then giant turn 4.
Agree.
What's happening? I don't know. What about nothing?
Now we have to kill it. So Fan of Knives with dagger attack, right?
Yeah, I think you're happy to do that too, because it's much the best value you'll get ever.
Ganging up the big game hunter.
Oh my god, the giant's value. You know what? That would be really nice. That's a really nice
big game hunters balanced
line of thought. So collateral cool here would be amazing because you can then sap the giant to death.
Oh! Big plays!
This is exactly what he wanted to see. Puts his opponent at 10 cards, prep, sap, and then gang up.
What? Why prep? Why prep, sap?
Because you want to gang up as soon as possible. Oh, yeah. Or you prep, gang up. Pick your point, whatever. You want to gang this up. There's no way you don't gang up your cold light.
Bing!
They say going back to the deck.
They should be saying that like in reverse, you know?
Oh yeah, right. Because they're going back to the deck.
Oh, right. So he should spawn now, right?
What if it actually spawned a legendary when it died like that? So Emperor is essentially a card that says, I will vomit my hand on this board as soon as possible. Thank you very much. Please do not vanish. P.S. Firebat loves you. So we have no Shadow Step yet. If Azure Drake draws one, though, things could get a bit tricky. Otherwise, Azure Drake Backstab does take care of this quite nicely. If he finds Shadow Stab, it's going to be hilarious. I mean, can you really afford letting the Emperor live no matter
what? No, you can't. No, you can't. Yeah. You have to kill.
You still have to trade, right?
Yeah.
Oh, well.
Deadly Poison? Well,
ah, you can keep the fish now if you want it.
Yeah, you can, but...
Do you want
the point of keeping the fish? Only for Vanish, right?
Sadly, yeah. Shadow Step and Vanish, yep. Those are the only reasons you'd keep them. So, Hellfire Coil, nope. Maybe, but not really.
You can do it.
Actually, it's not that bad. At 3 mana, I'm not even too worried about it.
Sap value now.
That's a good sap.
Do you do it? I think you do it, right?
It's not a bad sap.
So you sap into Goblin. Into
Redagger, I guess?
Nah, I wanted to say that you have to kill the Sunfear Protector. Or do you?
So you dagger, I mean, I don't know. I mean, you do have to kill it. But... Because, I mean, otherwise it combos with Hellfire a bit too well, perhaps, for your taste. So what about just you play SI instead of Sapper?
Yeah, and use the dagger, right? And then you redagger at the end of the turn. Doesn't seem to be bad. You want
I don't
the goblin
know why
as
I see
soon
playing
as possible?
Sappers. I still don't understand why the Sappers are in this deck. I'm trying to figure it out and I just don't get it. I'll have to ask Strifecro.
Oh, wow.
He kills the
Evisor. Wow, that's a huge commitment, wouldn't you say?
Yeah, that's a huge commitment to this board. I mean, now Hellfire Coil is better than it's ever been.
Wow, this is so bad.
And Firebat doesn't even wait 1 second. 3 mana of Hellfire Coil, count me in. 2 mana discount. He has to play a Belcher on the back end, just because.
I didn't like those two adversaries at all.
Oh, that's a good card. Well, sort of-ish, maybe. I don't know. Shadow Step or another Cold Light.
Emperor's
good.
Okay. Second Gengar, okay.
So half his deck will consist of Cold Lights.
Well,
it's getting a bit ridiculous.
I think you need those additional Cold Light Oracles because you lack any response to the creatures that will Warlock play.
Yeah, no,
this is
kind of
weird, right?
You need infinite Cold Lights.
Yeah.
That is exactly what you need. And I would even venture to say that you could... this guy's toast. Oh, well. He doesn't play into Shadow Step or Vanish. I was going to say you could even sap this to get yourself a good Vanish later and reuse your Cold Light afterwards.
What about the Ragnaros right now?
I don't know. Maybe not. You've got too many good plays besides that one. You're only weak to Vanish, really, and Lothib sealed that. He's not killing the fish because Shadow Step would cost an infinite amount of mana. 2 heal bots.
Well, this sucks. Emperor sucks. Straight out sucks. Heal bots?
I mean, most mill decks don't need to run Emperor. Albeit it's a good card in combo decks, you don't need it as much in Mill Rogue. But it's a very useful tool. It's just that in this position, it doesn't seem to help Strifecro very much. Well, I guess you do have to kill Lothab. Yeah, I think you just kill Lothab with your stuff and then you play Anti-Killbot and Redagger. That's a pretty boring play, but...
Yeah, I would say so.
Otherwise, you set up a double Healbot in the future, which is also not too bad. Just not the best line of play. You're going to get a free Deadly and a free 1-mana Sap. The one card you don't want to vanish is Lothab. I was watching Era recently, and he actually had to do that like 3 times in a row. And he ended up winning the game with Mail, but like it was crazy. He just had to do it nonstop. It was so frustrating to watch. Well, Swagnaros comes out.
Enter
That's
Ragnaros.
Not a sap target. I don't know what is. But double heal bot's pretty effective here. Puts him back to 28 health.
So that still doesn't do much.
Well, it helps. For now. You can
you
kill
need
a slime.
The draw from
deadly.
The Thalnos.
So you smack Thalnos on this board and the heal bot once, then sap rag? Or. Or do you not? You just not sap rag and you vomit your heal bot.
No, I have to do it. I think you have to do it.
Okay. So you have your sap rag and play Blood Mage for the draw. Well, Collateral Recall needs to be found as soon as possible. Again. And again. I seem to be saying that a lot, but. It's the biggest problem with Mill Rogue is the inconsistency of the Cold Light draw, even with Gang Up sometimes. It's one of my favorite cards from BRM, Gang Up that is. And really? Mill Rogue, it feels like there's an archetype lying there, but...
There's the Cold Light and there's the Cold Light.
Alright, so Shadow Step is going to help a lot here. If he finds the Shadow Step, a triple Cold Light into Shadow Step, Cold Light, that's three of them played back to back. I'm pretty sure he plays either the only one Shadow Step, because like probably only one Shadow Step. It's not played twice in every single mill. With Goblin Sappers, I'm not sure what he cut. Maybe the Earthling Farseers. Or he just got atrocious draws and he's just actually playing two and we just haven't seen any.
Well, he has to play the second one, right?
Yeah. What you want to find here is Prep Vanish. That's your best possible outcome, because everything dies on your opponent's board. That is the one thing you want to find here is Prep Vanish, back to back.
Oh, look. Cold Light Oracle into Cold Light Oracle. Nice.
Yeah. This is the only thing he wants here. Like, those five Cold Lights back to back are exactly what he was waiting for. Because that might win the game very soon. He finds the
There's
Vanish.
The Vanish.
Alright, so next turn should be a good turn for Strifecro.
Does he play Prep at all?
I think you have to if you play Vanish, otherwise you have too many weak turns. Many of your turns are weak. I feel...
You silence Ragnaros, go face, right? For 12, is it lethal?
No, it's not quite lethal. Because it doesn't deal the AoE. I mean... You have to get lucky.
Oh no, he has one owl. The second one was burned. Never mind.
Burned, yeah.
Mind.
The second one was milled.
Yeah.
So now this is the time where Strifecro may actually get a comeback. If Rag hits, say, one of the minions. If it hits FaZe, it's going to be a bit trickier, but...
Okay, it hits the Cold Light Oracle.
Oh man.
So now you need...
This is the dream. How many cards are currently
three,
in
six, Firebat? 7. Six. And the first cards being played was the two Ancient Watchers. And the Rag.
So if he plays double Cold Light, then he has preps in his deck. He's very likely to draw them. And I think that's the play he's going to go for
so
if he has...
If you play Cold Light and Vanish, then he only gets one Ancient Watcher into his hand. From the board.
He'll be on 8, so he'll get two Watchers, yeah. Well, one Watcher, one Rag, I think.
And lose everything. He has 7 cards, so he will be at 9. So he will get one card, so one Watcher.
One Watcher is all he'd get. You're right, never mind. I counted 8 for 6 for some reason. Yeah, you're right. At 7 cards, this is a perfect play. Cold Light Vanish, and you're good to go. There's no argument to be made here. You're right. I miscounted by 1. And he's almost out of cards. That should be game. Theoretically. Down goes the board. The Ancient Watcher is going to be watching for quite a while.
And well, get X phase, interesting, why?
Yeah, because he can just mill the opponent now. You triple Cold Light, you win right away.
Oh, okay. Right.
Yeah, it's an insta-kill.
yeah, right.
Mill Rogue. This is special tactics. Yeah. I think Goblin Sappers are the only weak part of the deck, but I suspect they might have been put in by Strifecro for the sake of improving the aggro matchup in a way, but then why not just play Farseers? That's the only question I've got. But
well, he burned the Goblin Sapper, so...
So he's got a shadow step left. He's got a shadow step left. So he's gonna calculate how much, you know, sequential or arithmetic leads to 20.
So he, you can play Cold Light Oracle. I don't know how many shadow steps he plays. But
well, he just needs to play those three. That's it. He wins. He doesn't need to do anything else. He's one of those three.
How much points of damage is that?
Like 22, 21? No, more than that, perhaps. I think it's close to that. Because it goes up to 10 after two cold lights.
Oh, two shadow steps.
Yeah. All right, so he does play two steps. Right. Yeah, so it's 10 damage for two cold lights, and then you get the 5-6, so it's like minus 1, effectively. Yeah, so it's 21 damage from 0 going with just cold lights.
Nice.
Draw! Auto win, mill versus handlock. That but took a long time for Strifecro to get
struggled.
There.
Yeah, he kind of struggled mid-game with the result.
Definitely, yeah. That was a really tough one for Strifecro, but ultimately, once you get those cold lights rolling, that matchup is very, very easy because you get one good vantage, the board is gone, as you saw. I can't believe I miscounted, but that was the perfect board wipe. It couldn't have gotten better for him. Give him a Nature Watcher, unactivated, and Firebat from there probably knew that the game was lost, so it's gonna be Mill Rogue, you know, sealing the game, so he's gonna have to move on to his one of his two other decks. It's gonna be the Warlock again, and Strifecro is gonna be playing his OTK Warrior next. And you said it was a good matchup, so
yeah, it should be.
That to be true.
It should be. It will come to a point when Firebat will have like the whole board with taunt creatures, right? And yeah. Strifecro will have just to play Brawl and hope that there will be no taunt creatures after the Brawl and just yeah. combo after that. That's it.
The thing is, I don't know if Strifecro is running one or two Brawls. That tends to be a difference between, you know, various lists from OTK Warrior, and that's one of the nuances that make it easier or tougher against aggro or against specific control decks. But a double Brawl in that deck makes hell of a lot of sense, so I wouldn't be surprised if he did.
True. We'll see in a few seconds. And well, we see at least one Brawl.
Yeah, that could be the same one we saw earlier, unfortunately. They need to put a
numbers on that.
Yeah, card tag on it, right? Brawl number one. So, do you keep the Brawl against Handlock?
I'm thinking about it.
Yeah.
I'm not sure. It might be too early, I think. He plays Shields Maiden, okay. So this is kind of a different...
It's not the double slam, yeah. Perhaps. Maybe there's not double slam the way that there are other things. Firebat finds the aggressive start with the Watcher Owl. Those guys are BFFs.
Okay. I can't even say what is the approach of Handlock here against the OTK Warrior. Well, he didn't see any cards from the OTK, right? He didn't see an
Inner Rage. He didn't see anything. He thinks this is a regular control warrior. Now he sees a loot hoarder and he's got to think to himself, wait, that's not the usual list. There's got to be something a bit different about this.
True.
So either this is a weird loot hoarder or... Like a weird loot hoarder in a control warrior list, or there's something very off here, but nothing earlier presaged, I guess, that this would be OTK war.
True.
Acolyte of Pain doesn't even send that message.
I'm really interested in how this will pan out. I'm like just watching it and thinking about it, you know, like an ordinary viewer, not a customer, because it's such an interesting match.
Yeah, I mean, what's interesting about it mostly is that it takes only a few turns for the setup to coalesce together to where suddenly the Warlock just gets obliterated. Like, he needs to get a really solid taunt line to get everything done.
Mm-hmm. What do you think about silencing the Ancient Watcher to kill the Acolyte? To give him just one draw, but you have a creature on board.
What Firebat probably figured out is this is Combo Warrior. I can't let him draw ever.
But the combo warrior has to deal with the creatures on board. So you automatically put pressure on him.
I guess you do. I mean, your watcher would usually die as a follow-up most of the time. Either way. We'll have to see how things go, but... And Firebat is tapping a lot.
Like crazy.
Yeah. Strifecro's got to feel like that's pretty nice. If he plays Gnomish Inventor, this is going to be so telling.
Charge and Brawl, and we still don't know which one is it.
So if Firebat wasn't sure whether this was Control Warrior or not, I mean, OTK Warrior, now he knows. I think the Loot Hoarder and Gnomish Inventor give it away for sure.
For sure. The creature's like, oh, faceless.
Oh yeah, he's playing the Emperor Thorsen version. Oh my god. Okay, that's gonna get interesting very soon. He's got the Worgen and the charge. If he finds Emperor, this could get very nasty very quickly.
But your Emperor has to, like, wait a turn, right?
One turn. Worgen for two, charge for two, faceless for four, and then you enrage it with Whirlwind for zero or something.
Oh, I get it. No.
You just punch face. If you got inner rage, that's even better. Because you give it extra.
He had the inner rage.
He does play them. He has to. It's a given in that deck. I think I like Healbot here. He's playing two BGHs. Whoa. Hallucination commencing. I wonder what is keeping the I wonder what's keeping the owl for.
I don't know, man.
Exactly. You've got me puzzled here, because I'm actually not sure if Firebat spotted the deck that he's playing up against.
I'm not sure either.
Right, I'm now guessing he did, because why... Then again, he did just see Mailrogue, so he's not... He might just be at a loss for words.
Well, you want to play the Garhul next turn, most likely. You don't have any other place. So what about killing the Watcher now? Killing the Sun Fury and Shields Maiden. Right? And then you have...
Yeah, Shields Maiden now might be a bit better as well.
You think so?
Yeah. Because you can actually Shield Slam that Watcher right off the bat and keep applying pressure. And you can keep that weapon activated for when you need to play the Worgen. Like, he's low enough now that he's about to die to Worgen. Like, it's just this close.
Yeah, that's
true. You're getting there. And you can always punch face for 7 with Gorhal and SM Orchid. I've got the beast in my
face. Okay, so he knows what it is, because no one sane would do that.
against Control Warrior, yes, indeed. Yeah. There's no way he would. Alright, so, is there a lethal looming around? There's an Execute, so Worgen plus Charge.
How much points of damage is that? That's 3, that's 5, that's 6, 12. 12 with the charge and Worgen.
Plus 5, yes, actually, that is lethal. That is lethal, alright, yeah, Strifecro's got it. That was
Execute
quick.
Sun Fury, so you got 7 mana. Then you have Worgen charge and attack for 6. Into 5-3. Attack into 5-3. And kill it and you get 12. Yeah, that's lethal. Easy lethal. Or am I missing something? I'm sure it's...
No, you're not. That is in fact lethal. This is a rest and pepperoni scenario. Well, so it came to pass that OTK Warrior, after a long, long absence from the metagame,
that's not an
is
OTK,
coming back.
Right? It's only 12 points of damage from the hand. It's less than Druid.
But it's still, as far as warriors go, though, that's a sick amount of burst.
It's right? The same as Grommash, man.
Yeah, but it doesn't feel that low. Because, I mean, playing Worgen with charge and inner rage is something very different. Oh, my God. Maybe it's not as OTK as I wish it were. You know what? People say it's not OTK if you played a card before. That's what they say.
Like the whole...
It has to come, like, straight up from hand. From 30 to 0 from hand. Like, Trolden mode. Otherwise, it's not a real OTK.
With the sex on.
Exactly. If you don't have the sacks, it's not a real OTK. So that is going to be an equalization of the series, which makes, which forces Strifecro to go up to his mage deck. If this is Fatigue Mage, No, we haven't seen anything, but this is Fatigue Mage.
I would say he's targeting the Warlock, right?
I mean, that would be crazy. Double BGH in a Warlock deck.
Why not just Freeze Mage? You get really great...
You're still fine with
great
it,
great chances against Handlock. Basically, just burst him down when he's at 15. And that's it.
I'm really curious to see what Strifecro brought for Mage. His Mill Rogue panned out against Handlock. His OTK Warrior pans out against Handlock. And his Mage might do the same.
True.
Oh my OTK. No way. This is it. This is the OTK. With Sorcerer's Apprentices and Archmage Antonidas.
Why are you saying that?
Because Echo of Medivh? But it might... Okay, it might not
it might
be that.
Be just,
right.
It might
right.
be just usual Fatigue yeah. Mage.
I'm living the dream. I'm living the dream in my head. I want this to be the OTK. I want to see a Sorcerer's Apprentice, please. No, none of that.
Value Mage.
Well, it's nothing bad. I mean, there's like 6 archetypes of Mage floating around, so I'm not going to complain. Makes for a difference compared to all the Mech Mages that we used to see ubiquitously about a month ago.
True.
I'd say 2 weeks ago, even. What am I talking about? He does not play the Zombie Chow. I guess he doesn't want to give the opponent, an incentive to life tap.
You think so?
I don't know. I'm trying to figure it out. Playing Zombie Chow, what does it play into, maybe?
Well, you ping it and go face?
Yeah, the question is whether or not he plays Zombie Chow afterwards. That's what I'm curious about.
I don't think he played it.
If he didn't play turn 1, the why?
Yeah, what's the reason to play it?
It dies to Hellfire and he gets the health back. Maybe you want to play it after the first Hellfire has been forced. That's a possible decision. I will have to see.
2 Twilight Drakes would be a really big problem for Strifecro, I think.
Yeah, unless he has some kind of fancy magic that sounds them in Mage. It's not uncommon to see Iron Bical in Mage, but not that often.
Ice Barrier go face? There's no other play. You have your 10-5 with the Belcher, you have your 10-6 with the Belcher.
Yeah, I think so. You can probably force the opponent to play into MC Tech at some point. Right?
I think it will be tough. Because Firebat might play around it.
Alright, he was checking for Mirror Entity here with a Washer. He's gonna check for Duplicate with Zombie Chow. Probably. I mean, he would never expect Strifecro to make such a mistake as feeding him 2 Zombie Chows.
No, I don't think so.
But he wanted to make sure. He wanted to make sure.
And you sacrifice the Mad Scientist into the Twilight Drake to avoid Shadow Flame, right? Or just go face for the Echo of Medivh. No, you keep it for the Echo of Medivh, yeah.
I was gonna say, if you can get an Echo with the Mad Scientist stuff, that'd be great, but... I mean, that's not even a great Shadow Flame. It's a decent one, but it's not a great one. How well does Value Mage do against Handlock in general?
I think I'm not the person you want to ask that question.
Yeah, I'm gonna ask Crip. How good is Value Mage?
Crazy good!
So, as you know, I've been playing around the ladder with Value Mage. And... I don't play the decks that people usually play, but... I had a lot of fun with it, and surprisingly, Echo of Medivh has given me incredible value. I'm pretty sure that's about the gist of it, because that's pretty much what the deck tries to do, right? Like, yeah. It just tries to outvalue with Echo of Medivh and duplicate, except now we haven't seen a single bit of those. Well, they haven't had a chance to be used. Yeah. Do you like playing Echo here, just to make sure you get another Belcher and Mad Scientist?
I think so. I think you have to play the Echo of Medivh, because if you just play the Belcher, you are in fear of Hellfire and Shadow Flame. So
lose the board.
You lose the board, and the Echo of Medivh becomes a blank.
Yeah. Well, let's see what ends up happening here. So he kills one of the Drakes. And just goes face with the Mad Scientist. This guy has done a lot of damage so far. Crazy amount, actually. Firebat is not yet ready for the Shadow Flame.
Hmm.
Oh, wow. That would have been nice off of Guarantor Mage. If there was a Guarantor Mage. So how much do you Flame Strike? How often do you Flame Strike here? Probably not very often. I don't very much see a reason for this.
Well, you can't deal with the giant anyway, so I don't see a reason to play the Flamestrike yet.
He's gonna get pretty good value out of it later on, though. Interestingly enough, though, Sludge Belcher and Duplicate together are pretty sick on the same turn. If Firebat doesn't play Lothab, that works. Uh-oh.
Will he play the Sun Fury? Oh, now we'll get Mind Control value.
What? If he... Now, no matter what he gets, I mean, I guess the Sun Fury is the worst.
Okay, the Sun Fury is really bad, but if other steals are really great.
I think you just slam that.
Yeah, I think so.
Then you play... Oh, man. Come on. RNGesus, Jesus, what will you give today? Nothing. What is he like? When do you get a better MC?
I don't think there's a better situation, because you have like a 75% chance of winning something.
So what if you just wait one turn and force your opponent to play into your board even further? Like, he's thinking about flame striking. I think,
don't think he will play anything. Why would you play anything on that board?
Yeah, that's what I'm wondering as well. Because, I mean, if you don't play anything, that's because you're afraid of Flamestrike. So I think it's a matter of either MC Tech.
So those...
Actually, he could go for Mad Scientist, Water Ellie, ping one of the 5 health minions to reduce them to Flamestrike range.
What about if he wants to ping the Sun Fury to kill... Oh no!
Horrible damage. This is terrible.
Never lucky.
And now that's a decent Shadow Flame.
Yeah.
I mean, I think I'd take that Shadow Flame all day. Yeah, that's just... Yeah.
That was very unlucky.
But at least Strifecro is going to get a good Flame Strike with the Flame Strike ping on Lothab. Like, he's going to be taking 13 damage, but at least...
13 damage, man.
Yeah, I mean, it's better than nothing, at the very least. Because you do have follow-ups with the Belcher, Water Ellie, and everything. You're still okay. It's just really problematic for right now. And there are 2 secrets up. One
what
of which
did
is
you get with the... Oh, never mind.
No, you got 1 secret. Never mind. I think I... Alright.
So he has the second secret, and that's Ice Block, right?
I would think so. It could be Mirror Entity, I guess.
Nope. He would have gotten the...
He would have gotten the minion earlier. Yeah.
Yeah.
Unless it's been Iceberry all along. Because that's the first time he gets attacked. And this may be Mirror Entity. Because Shadow Flame was only played this turn. So maybe he got a Mirror Entity from the Mad Scientist.
Okay. That would make sense. Oh!
Nice top deck! Alright, that's a great card, but... How great?
It's pretty great.
I mean, it's just feeding Flamestrike value for Strifecro at this point. You don't know it, but it's there. It's definitely there.
Second Big Game Hunter?
Yeah, he plays 2 in this deck.
Interesting.
Yeah, would have been great.
He predicted a whole different meta. Oh, so he played the Belcher because he had the Duplicate. Okay, makes sense.
Ouch! This Flamestrike is gonna hurt. Oh, this perfect flame strike.
Perfecto. Now we have to play it, right?
This
There's
is
no
crazy.
Reason not to play it.
I mean, I can't even think what else I would play here. Am I playing Arena here or what? Yep, definitely feels like Arena.
We need the duplicate for spells.
He did not attack with the water LE. Doesn't want to see Molten Giants, is my guess. Since he doesn't have a, like an immediate answer to it.
He doesn't have an immediate answer to this too. What he can do is just drop the Belchers. Two Belchers? Seems to be okay. You will get a really huge Echo of Medivh next turn. But how do you deal with the Ragnaros now?
Mage, unless they're running the Polymorph, always have a problem with it. And that's a good hit. Well, no Polymorphs yet.
I don't think he runs a Polymorph.
It's usually that type of deck tends to run the one to make sure they don't get taken off guard. Because Ragnaros is a really big problem minion for decks like these. Unless they have like an overkill of spells, but a lot of them tend to cut removal, like fireballs, to play more value minions.
So double Belcher. Double Belcher and you want to damage the Ragnaros next turn for 3 points of damage for flame strike.
Damage, yeah.
But this is such a huge commitment.
You could play Belcher and duplicate, I guess, if you wanted to get more of those. Or you could set up an amazing Echo of Medivh. So you hope Rag hits your face, you get a really good Echo. It's not too bad.
Dr. Bomb.
Man, those sneeze. The board from Firebat is...
Those sneeze? So you anticipate more sneeze?
Another
from the sneeze?
Yeah, there's always going to be another sneeze in the sneeze.
Infinite circle of violence. Oh, that's bad.
Wow. And that is exactly what he wanted.
What about
wipe the board? I mean, I guess you try. You're gonna leave him with a legendary, but
oh man. So why don't you just play Sludge Belcher?
Echo? Sludge Belcher, Mad Scientist?
No, Sludge Belcher, Echo seems to be okay.
Yeah, I don't hate that. Because he will attack with the Sneed, so you will be able to get more value later on. So, alternatively, I guess there's a Sludge Belcher, Mad Scientist duplicate play that I don't dislike too much, because the Belcher will be the first one to take the hit, theoretically, but...
The problem is, doesn't he even attack phase? We know there's no Molten Giants. In Firebat's hand.
Firebat.
We know that. He doesn't know that. And he didn't attack at 21. So I bet he won't attack now too. Either. Does it make any sense? How do you want to win?
Well, that's the thing. Grinder Mage tends to be a deck that takes forever to ramp up. Right? That's just the way that the deck operates.
True.
And usually it just wears you down over 25 hours.
Oh, that's a lot.
That's the average control warrior match, but Mage found a way to make it last that long. So you Dr. Boom and then you BGH your own Dr. Boom to help. Or you Iron Beak Owl Rag to trade into something. No way. Well, duplicate's gonna hit. And now there's a decent flame strike on the horizon for Strifecro.
And 8 points of damage to the face.
That's the best possible outcome.
That's true.
That is the best possible outcome.
You still have a really big problem.
Wait.
You have to attack first into Dr. Boom, right? Because what happens if the bomb will kill your Belcher?
You play Deathlord and hope for the best. No, I think you have to attack Boom first, then you Flame Strike and play Deathlord. Or you play Deathlord just before that if you feel like it. I mean, there's a good Echo of Medivh looming around if you feel like taking that. It's not so bad. It's just that. One Iron Beak Owl. If you're playing only, if you only have one Belcher on the board, one Iron Beak Owl is all it takes to ruin you.
That's actually true. And there's one Iron Beak Owl already there.
Yeah, so it's just a matter of getting that one card.
So if he plays Deathlord, he wants to play Mad Scientist and one Belcher, right? Nah, that makes no sense.
Well, there we go. Select your damage. 4 damage to Airy Face. Oh, are you kidding me? At least the slime took the hit for the team.
That Matryoshka.
Did you see that? This is not a sneeze, but it's close enough, right?
Yeah, that's close enough. That's like a twin yet.
Oh my goodness.
It has been a long time from when I saw the last Cairn or Corn. Or whatever.
Artosis, it's not Karn. It's not Karn. Yeah, I was gonna say Artosis. Get out of this body. I'm gonna remind you, this is not Karn.
Where's the Blade Fury?
The Blade Fury and the Karn. Oh man, those cards are sick.
Wow.
I exec cutted my own Sylvanas.
So I don't know even how much secrets are out there in Strifecro's deck. I would assume there's one more because he played the, like, he was...
Ice Barrier we saw?
No, I mean, he was really pushing for that Mad Scientist last turn. So unless, he wouldn't do that unless there's a really crucial secret that he wants to get now.
Well, okay, you're wrong. I don't know how we're so wrong all the time, Lothar, but we are. I'm sorry. That seemed like a really... Is this lethal, actually?
Wait, you...
With Iron Beak Owl, Siphon Soul? Nah, so, not quite. No, close enough.
It's 8 points of damage.
You've seen 2 Flame Strikes in Firebat's, head here. So you're not too worried about anything, you know, drastic, really worrying you. You could just play it very slowly and casually.
So what about sacrificing Big Game Hunter? Mortal Coiling?
That's not bad at all, that's great.
And then you play Emperor?
Isn't there a lethal with Hellfire and Iron Beak? Hellfire, Iron Beak? No, there's none. I'm pretty sure there's something along those lines though, but I can't quite pinpoint it. It's late. It feels late.
Yeah, that feels right.
That's a really good play anyway. It's not like he's really worried about losing anything.
Yeah.
I mean, worst case scenario, there's a second MC tech, but, you know, it doesn't matter at all.
I don't see a comeback from Strifecro in this situation.
It's Mill Mage.
What?
Yeah, the Grinder Mage.
Okay, so he didn't get the Codlight Oracles early enough. And this is biting him back now, I think.
I wasn't aware that his list for Grinder Mage ran Cold Lights. Like, he made a hybrid of it. Interesting. Well, what could he find from Cold Light? Does he run Novas? In that deck, if he does, that's, you know, a possible outcome that would be really good for him. Okay, so it is a mix of Grinder Mage and...
And Anoyotrons.
No, Grinder Mage runs Anoyotrons and Zombie Chows. It's just that... I haven't seen the Cold Light in that initial list. Maybe it's now tailored a bit around Handlock. Shadow Flames out. That could still be lethal, unless I'm mistaken. So you attack into...
Wait, how much is
no, it? Siphon Soul might cover it.
Siphon Soul, and you have Owl. So that's 5, 6, and Hellfire. Do you need the Owl? No, you don't need Owl. So he gets Hellfire.
Yeah, he's close to lethal, but not quite.
3,
yeah.
8, 10, 15, 18 points of damage. That's it.
Yeah. Well, I don't know that Strifecro can really come back from this.
I don't see how it happens.
Yeah, an ice block, perhaps. And then another cold light. No, there's... Into Echo of Medivh cold light, perhaps. That's not... I mean, it's a back-to-back top deck war, but... If he runs two cold lights in this weird variant, it's possible. He's at least gonna make sure Echo of Medivh doesn't do what it wants to do. Alright, well, Scryfcrow, it's on you.
What do you do, Deathwing?
That Escape Concede's really a great play.
You get, you will leave your opponent with 4-5 and a 12-12 because he gets wrecked by the Sylvanas. Right, yeah.
So Deathlord, Echo, yeah. Deathlord, I guess. That's the only thing I can even see that does anything at all here. And it doesn't do much. It just sort of stops the incoming damage. You're cutting off a bit here.
What?
Never mind, you're back. Owl? I mean, what is Strifecro hoping to do here?
I'm not sure.
Yeah, Strifecro is the type of player who takes his sweet time no matter what the game, just to try to make sure that he makes the optimal play no matter what, even if he thinks in the end it might not matter. That's something I've seen him do quite often. I mean, against Handlock, you don't expect this move to really accomplish anything.
Yeah, this is G.
Yep, this Iron Beak Owl is going to seal the game, signs the Deathlord, go full face with everything, and Strifecro is going to fall down to Handlock. So this is a really hybrid version of, I think, a deck that Strifecro's been playing quite a bit of, and I suspect Strifecro might have been targeting Handlock with that lineup, because it felt like it was very strong against that specific thing. Even though the mage at the very end lost, that Deathlord and that Collateral Cult give me that vibe.
Well, too bad that Strifecro lost his perfect score. It's 4-1 now.
Yeah,
right.
He's 4-1.
He's still first in his group, right?
Yeah, I think he's got the same score as Life Coach right now, right? The two players who are highly rated in the Kinguin Pro League at this point.
Yeah, they are.
So that means Firebat's going to be able to go up 3-4, I think. He lost to 6-0 just before. To Savage just before, so he was 3-4. Now I think he's going to go up to 4-4.
Savage,
no, wait, that makes no sense at all. Firebat lost 3-4, and now he's going up 4-4. No way he's played that many matches in the game. No way he's played that many matches so far. Anyway, that being said, yeah. Firebat went 1-1 in the days today. I don't have the official rankings ahead of me. They've not been updated as far as I know. I think he's 4-3 with a chance to climb up after Strifecro if everything goes well for him.
I think you're right.
Yeah.
Well,
4-3
what's
in the
important.
Series.
If the viewers want to see the Strifecrow's decklist, then you can find those on kinguin.net/proleague. And so I would definitely take a look into that.
I will. I'm really curious what he was playing. So on this note, guys, this was the last match of the day. Now, before we leave, I'd like to remind you that this weekend, and I will remind you on Thursday, but this weekend, on Friday, we'll have the Kinguin for Charity event. So that's another edition of it. It's going to be the Easter edition for 2015. We'll have 16 players, a fresh roster that's been put together for that specific event. The first of many for hopefully the entire year. And also, Kinguin is looking for casters as well. We still haven't stopped looking. So if you guys want to get into casting for Hearthstone, just send your, a VOD of yourself casting over a game at esports@kinguin.net, and you might be selected for a cast-off in the Kinguin Studios. That's a great opportunity, and I'd urge you to try it. So quite a good conclusion, I'd say, to the day. We had a long series.
Oh, yeah, that's true. Oh, a lot of 3-2s, actually. RDU was 3-2 against Reynard. Strifecro against Firebat was 3-2. Savage versus Firebat was 3-2. And
I think Sho was 3-1, perhaps. Versus Gar, I think it might have 2-3 as well, right?
I can't remember now. Too many matches.
Everything seems like... The series were very long. The match was interesting. I expected a lot more Face Hunter in two-minute games, but I was fortunately disappointed. So that's going to be it for the day, guys. We'll be back on Thursday. I think Lothar will be traveling, so I'll be accompanied by Monk if all goes well. So until I see you guys on Thursday, take care of yourselves. Thanks for watching.
Thanks for watching, guys.
Have a nice one.